We're what's known in common parlance as peculiar. 51 seconds late, Fiona.
Sorry, Miss Peregrine. How many carrots do you need for supper?
Just one will do.
From the moment I read the book, I could picture it as a movie, and most particularly as a movie directed by Tim. And the idea of being involved in that was tremendously exciting.
Peculiars have been persecuted through the ages. Hence, we live in places like this. I'm a type of peculiar called an imbrine.
Yeah, you turn into a bird.
Well, I do, yes.
The visuals are a massively strong part of the book, and so, you know, it's not a huge leap to see it in a cinematic sense, but also that there's something about the atmosphere of the book, and I really love the creepiness, and it has a really unusual energy about it, and something that I could see really translating beautifully to screen.
An imbrine's main skill is the manipulation of time. We choose a safe place, a safe day, and create a loop.
What do you mean?
Well, a loop preserves the last 24 hours. Reset the loop, and the day is yours to live in again. Reset it daily, and you can stay there forever.
Essentially, a time loop is a 24-hour span of time in which the same things happen again and again, but those that live in it can react differently, interact differently. I think the pop culture reference of Groundhog Day is probably the way to most clearly describe it to anyone. In the story, imbrines are able to reset a 24-hour period of time. You can live in it indefinitely, and so while in it, you don't age, and things don't change until you step outside of it.
You met the twins. This is Claire.
The notion of peculiars is that some people are born peculiar, and that means that they have a peculiarity of some sort. And, you know, peculiarities are very hard to define because it's somewhere between a sort of a physical anomaly to what could almost be a kind of not very useful superpower. It was hard to nail down. It was, you know, I think our feeling was, a peculiarity when you see one, but it's very hard to define what, where the boundaries are for, anomalies, superpowers. Peculiarities are somewhere here. But it's something that makes you strange and different, but it doesn't, it makes you neither better nor worse than another human, just different.
Millard, you met.
Come on!
And that's you.
Stop cheating, you!
The word genius is probably way overused when people talk about Tim, but it's very hard to avoid using it because there is just something exceptional about the way his mind works, and it's just been such a joy and a privilege to work with him. I love the ideas that come out of nowhere, and it's just, whatever he's doing feels, you just feel like you're in the most creative possible environment. And so, yeah, God, it's been an absolute pleasure.